Well, let's see. Now, I want to show you one of my favorites here, okay? This is, and this ties in with the story today, okay? This here, all right, this here, I have never, they didn't make trucks like this when I was a kid. I wasn't into trucks so much, but this is an absolutely amazing truck. I looked at it and I said, this could only have been designed by Germans because this thing is so accurate. There's a German engineer in the room, so it's a compliment actually that I'm an engineer, and German engineers are amazing to me. Is that the things that they do? They're so good. I think American engineering is pretty good, but my hats off go off to the Germans, honestly. So I looked at this and said, this could only be designed by a German engineer, and sure enough, you look at the front of the truck, okay, it's a Mercedes truck. So it's a concrete mixer. So when I was living in Europe, you'd see trucks like this. Mercedes does make trucks as well as expensive cars. So the amazing thing about this is, as a civil engineer, my job is to design things, a lot of which are built in concrete. And so after we come up with the drawings and the specifications, then we have to watch the construction to see if they're building it right. So I was on a job within the last year where they were pulling one of these things up about every 10 minutes to drop off, and they were just pouring concrete in this massive underground structure. I was lowered in a basket about, 250 feet below the surface of the earth, watching them place concrete. So they just keep pouring, they're bringing these trucks just like this. So I understand when I'm looking at this truck, all the features of this truck, they've got this little adjustable chute in the back of the truck, and they've got, this turns around and this lifts up so you can have access to servicing engine. All these things are realistic. This is amazingly accurate, just like the trucks are. So I'm looking at this thinking, I cannot believe how realistic this is. It's a scale model of a truck that has like all the features on it. So a few days ago, I was down in the basement. Now, some people have finished basements in their houses, where you've got a rug there, you've got lights, and it's comfortable. And then there's other people who have the other kind of basement. Now, we have one of those kind of basements. Well, our kind of basement is, it's totally unfinished. It's a wonderful place for spiders and insects and small rodents and things like that to live. So I was walking down there and I saw up on the shelf this really cool truck, one of my grandson's favorite trucks. And so my first thought was, he must have done something really bad to get this truck banished to the basement. I'm thinking, okay, what did he try to kill his younger brother? What did he do? So I asked his father, what did Elijah do? And I appreciate the fact that he's disciplining his son and taking one of his toys away. I don't want to take anything away, but I'm just curious. What did he do that merited such a severe punishment of relegating his favorite truck to the basement here where he can't have access to it? And he said, the problem with this truck, he said, it's so realistic that it is, there's so many features on this thing. I mean, this is a concrete mixer where it turns around just like a real concrete truck does. And the chute and everything else. So he says he's playing with his truck and he can't figure out all these advanced things that the truck can do, what they're for. And so he just gets totally frustrated. He gets totally frustrated and would throw a fit. And he says, all right, you got to throw a fit with the truck. That's it for the truck. So, until you get yourself under control. So, amen. I appreciate his father doing what a good father should do, which is applying some discipline. But I thought, it's kind of like this with the tabernacle, because the tabernacle, whether you realize it or not, just like this German toy truck, is an incredibly accurate scale model of things that are incredibly important, okay? And if you don't understand the features of this model, you will get frustrated like Elijah and throw the Bible, throw this part of the Bible in the basement, never want to read it. So basically, that's the parable of the toy truck, which is, okay, if you like the real thing, then you should be really fascinated by the model, but you can get frustrated with the model if you don't understand the features and how they work. So the my desire in this lesson here is to open up your mind to the wonder of this great model that we're going to be taking a look at, and some of the features of the model. And so if you understand them, you really love them and appreciate them, there's a lot that we can learn here, but it's for us to play with, all right? And I want to start by a quote from Irenaeus. This is in a work called Proof of the Apostolic Preaching. It's not in the Nicene Fathers. It's a separate work that was found later. And he's talking about the Old Testament. And I'm going to read from chapter 26. So Irenaeus is a bishop of the church in Lyon, which is in Gaul, modern-day France, writing around the year 180, very early Christian writer. He's talking about the Old Testament. And he says, he's talking about the law of Moses. He's writing to a young Christian. He says, "And in the desert, Moses received from God laws, 10 sentences on tablets of stone written with the finger of God. And finger of God is that which is put forth by the Father and the Holy Spirit, and the commandments and laws which he commanded to the children of Israel to be kept. He also constructed at God's command the tabernacle of the testimony, a visible construction on earth of what is spiritual and invisible in heaven, and a figure of the form of the church, and a prophecy of things to be, and in it both vessels and altars and an ark in which he put the tablets." So this is so think about what Irenaeus is saying here. He's talking about the tabernacle, what we're about to start taking a look at. He said it's a visible construction of earth on earth of what is spiritual and invisible in heaven, and a figure and form of the church. So it's two different, there's two things that it's modeling, and a prophecy of things that are yet to be. Now, this, of course, this is 1,400 years before Christ, so it means that hadn't happened yet. So the first thing, before we get into the details, I want to help us to appreciate why this matters, okay? Not just that Irenaeus said so, but the New Testament writers are really saying the same thing on both points, that it's a model of things in heaven. It's also a picture of the church. And I want to take a look at a few passages in the New Testament from Paul's writings to think about this. Now,